In early July of 2022, Apple announced a new feature coming to iOS 16 called Lockdown Mode. Now, while it's marketed as an extreme feature meant to protect users who are at high risk of government-sponsored spyware, so think people like journalists, activists, politicians, and so on, what I want to know is exactly what this lockdown mode actually does, and if there would be any benefit or even drawbacks for people like you and me to use it. So here's what we know so far. Welcome to All Things Secured, a channel dedicated to helping you secure your digital life and build better privacy online. My name's Josh, and since I've personally been targeted and monitored during my time in a sensitive part of China, I was naturally curious and honestly a little bit excited about this announcement from Apple. Now, keep in mind, this lockdown mode is not available till the fall, so don't go looking for it on your phone right now. This is just an explanation of what it is based on their press release, and then of course my first impressions. You see, lockdown mode is meant to harden your device against sophisticated attacks by limiting certain functions on your device and then completely disabling other kinds of connections. What does this mean? Well, for example, if my iPhone, iPad, or MacBook is in lockdown mode, I won't be able to receive anything other than text and images in the Messages app. Any link previews, PDFs, or other kinds of files, which might even include movie files, that's not entirely clear, are going to be entirely blocked. Now, I don't know about you, but that doesn't sound half bad. I don't want people messaging me and sending me files, to be honest. And the only place I can see some potential problems would be if they block video files, which my wife and I use to often send videos among family. In addition to these limitations on messages, Apple will also block certain web technologies as you browse the internet, things like some types of JavaScript. Again, there's not much detail yet about which technologies are being blocked and what kind of effect this would have on user experience. A lot of what this kind of blocking feature protects you and I from would be things that we normally wouldn't even see or know exist. Things like document preview that downloads malicious code, or even a website that loads a malicious font. In the end, some of the web pages we visit might not load correctly with lockdown mode on, but Apple does note that I can whitelist certain websites, meaning that those websites I trust, I can tell Apple not to block these web technologies on those sites, which should make this another really no-brainer feature. My only question at this point is, how might this affect users who don't use Apple's native Safari browser? So if I'm using Firefox, for instance, this protection is supposed to still exist, but perhaps the user experience would be even worse? I don't know yet. Now, moving beyond messaging and internet browsing, Apple says that lockdown mode will block incoming invitations and service requests unless I, as the user, have called or sent that particular user a request already. Apple references FaceTime as an example here, where a complete stranger couldn't call me on FaceTime unless I had already called their number first, as well as shared photo on Apple's Photos apps, those albums that you can share among other people. But I'm not sure what else this will include. Incoming phone calls, AirDrop, I'm not sure. And again, this is something we won't really know until a beta version is released. But the truth is that I'm all for blocking any kind of incoming request from a user that I haven't approved first. There are times that I get a call from a delivery driver that would probably get blocked in this mode, but I can live with that. Okay, here's a fun fact for you. Did you know that if somebody plugs directly into your phone, it's possible for them to have full access to your device? Now, I know this because when living in China, the police would set up checkpoints where they would randomly pull people aside, have them unlock their phones and plug them into this mysterious device. You'd wait for a few seconds and then they'd give you the all clear and you'd be on your way. Now, I reached out to Apple at the time to see what data the police would have access to when plugging in, and their response was that as long as the device had been unlocked with the correct passcode, all data was available. I know China isn't the only country to have figured this out, so it's interesting to see that in this lockdown mode, all other wired connections are blocked. Basically, the Lightning and USB-C port on your device will be good for nothing more than charging, and even then you may have to unlock it before it starts to charge. Finally, Apple's new lockdown mode prohibits the use of mobile device management profiles, which is something often used by businesses to control all of their company devices. The end result here, and keep in mind that I haven't had the chance to test this out on a real device yet, but the end result is that the limitations imposed by lockdown mode are something that I wouldn't mind having myself. In other words, unless it somehow stops a lot of my other apps that I use on a daily basis from working, everything they're promoting about this new security mode is something I think most people should use, not just the small minority who are at higher risk of being attacked. Apple calls it groundbreaking. But from what I see so far, it looks more like a what took you so long kind of feature set. But that's my two cents. What's your take? Anything I'm missing here, please leave them in the comments below and make sure you're subscribed so that you can watch my follow-up video once I am able to actually beta test iOS 16 later this summer.